G'day, Trader Sam here from Trade to Prosper to give you another crypto review. Bitcoin. We're going to do a comparison between the previous bull runs and the accumulation period. So let's have a look at 2015, 2017, 18, and the current. What we're going to do is going to look at the monthly, the weekly, and the daily, compare it with a number of indicators, RSI, MACD, Bollinger Band, and Ichimoku Cloud. Just to be quick about it, not spending too much time on this. I'm trying to keep it down below 30 minutes. So let's begin. We can see that from this RSI in the past, they were flat. The bottom was pretty much matched. And that was a nice accumulation structure as well in the past. And therefore, this level was prevalent. Here we see we break down below it. There's a number of levels that we broke previously. The bottom on this one, once we break that level there, we actually went further down and past the previous support, and now it's acting as resistance, as you can see. So what we want to see this is go above it. That's what I think, to get a confirmation that this is going somewhere. At the moment, this could easily come back up there and come back down and then up again. So the monthly really depends on the monthly. What I should also mention with the monthly is the candlesticks. So in the past, we had a capitulation candle, this one here. And although we had another one, we had a bullish candle and that engulfed the others. And that was an indicator to go bullish. Also regaining the 200 weekly SMA, which is this green one here, as you can denote it from this. So that was a good sign. Once you break the 200 weekly moving average, if you and the daily as well. Although, so what we have is a number of candle moving averages. The 21 monthly moving average is a significant one, and we have support on the weekly 200 SMA. But the bullish candlestick was the sign to go for it, and it broke the 50% on the RSI. So a combination and the 21 monthly moving average, that was a good indication that this is a bull run. Similarly, we've got our 50% level here. The moment we break that with a bullish candle, as well as we had a capitulation candle and then followed by a bullish candle, that's pretty much the 50% level and up it goes. Same here, we had a really selling client, the bullish, bearish candle, and you can see the wicks that was a good buy. Found our 200 similar to the others, 200 a weekly RMA, and up it went. So with this bullish candle, we started the bull run. It broke the 200 and the 20 monthly moving average as well. So when we're looking at this one here, the candlestick, it has a capitulation candle, very similar to these ones, and this one here. And what we want to see is another. So we're seeing one weekly candle that's bullish. We're seeing probably another bullish candle. Still, if you really want to be confident, like I said, you want to see it go above this level and also a bullish candle on the monthly to find your entry. But you don't want to miss out. So obviously, we need to look at a small time frame. And you can see from these charts that the candlesticks are prevalent from the monthly perspective, and the RSI is also giving us a good indication on when it could go bullish. As we are on the monthly chart, it's not going to be really advantageous us to look at the MACD, because the MACD will probably not give us any help besides these two Instagram histograms being bullish. That's not going to really help. We still have a whole month. We were pretty early in the month of November, so that's not going to really help us out at all as well. But when we look at this RSI, I do feel like this should be above it to start thinking bullish. All right, let's go to the weekly. Looking at the weekly, in the previous 2015, we had this, what you can say is a rising RSI. And Here we also had a rising RSI that sort of held its level and kept going. And we're also having one at the moment, so we want to keep that going. On the weekly, what we've seen is when it broke the 50% level, and this one, it went a fair bit, but it hit the 0.382 Fibonacci based on this swing high to swing low. So it played the accumulation for a longer period. Here we had a triangle, ascending triangle, so we can get into those details. But what we can see from this is that the line was held. Yep. It was held all the way and the bull run continued on. What we're seeing here right on this one here is that when you break the 50%, the bull run started, and here 50%, the bull run started. So we had one break and pullback. So you can say that's a one. You can say roughly that's a two. And that's a three move. One, two, three. Yep. And then up it kept on going. And here we can say that that was the top one, two, and a three. So we can say that that matches our sigma move. One, two, three. And then we had this ABC. And so we have an ABC. And then it went. So there's two variations to this. This sigma structure and then this typical bottom accumulation and then the bull run. So it really didn't slow down after its accumulation. This one obviously took longer, and I would think this will probably play out the three sigma move. Yeah, so that is our one, potentially two, three somewhere, ABC, and then that could play out. But anyway, looking at the RSI, this is all what we notice is that when it broke the previous resistance, it went bullish. Here, when we break that previous resistance, it went bullish, and then it sort of went dip below it, but then when it went back over it, it went. Here, we can say that this is our resistance, and we're going bullish. Question is it going to play this out? That's the question. We can also see on the weekly that the MACD has gone bullish as well. We crossed over and it's getting wider. So we want to continue seeing this getting wider for the bullish momentum. What we also notice from this chart is that in the past, we had a number of bullish candles on the weekly. So there was no pullback. After we got a break this, which one is that? Okay, give me a sec. Once we've broken above this 233 weekly moving EMA, it started to become bullish as well. And this is the 200 daily moving average. So once we break that, we pretty much start the bull run, and it's roughly around the 50% RSI. So this combination, you can see we can take those lessons and apply them here. So when can we really go bullish on the weekly is we need to break this level. The 0.382 is the first, and the 0.5, really, where the 200 moving average on the daily is coming down, and we've got this 233. So this, and we've got the weekly 200 SMA. So this level is going to be a strong resistance. And it might be a situation where we could potentially, in my opinion, it's possible that we play this scenario out. We range longer, unfortunately. So it doesn't have, because it's early days, we don't have that 200 weekly stuff there. Actually, we do, but they're on the bottom. Here, because there's such a strong resistance, we might play this A, B, C, D, E, and then up. So we have our A, B, C, the free move, or one more down and then up. That could play out. Yep. There is also, it just really depends on if this was to get to the top there, then I would be comfortable with this move. Then I would say the bottom is in. But never know. So let's look at the RSI on this. We can get rid of that. And Yeah, we've got a long way to go. The only aspect to this is we have that trend line and it's breaking above it, the weekly. And we also have this one that sort of played the pivot right there. So you can see once we broke that, it went up. So it looks bullish. It doesn't necessarily mean it's going to go up. So that's from the RSI perspective. Here, I believe if we do the common line of some sort, that would have been it there. So we break this horizontal resistance and we break this trend line of some sort. You could probably even do this. Yep. Once we break that level, I think it went bullish from the RSI perspective. That seems to be the case. And when we look at this horizontal, that might be the case as well. Right, but we need to see evidence that you can go above this point 0.382. Here we had the 0.382 acting as resistance from this perspective, and then once we broke it, it went up. That was a clear good formation. Here the formation is not as clean, and therefore we want to see it break the 0.382 first, and then with my strategy, I've bought in somewhere down here with a small. And if it breaks, whoops, I should have done that. I think that was the level. Yep, the 0.382 there. And if we could break that, if we come back down from there, then that could play the other fractal, unfortunately. You could play this level here. So what we have here, I'm still very cautious of this fractal. It didn't go above the 50%. This hasn't gone above the 50%, still bearish. And it dropped. So it's not quite the same. But however, there's no reason why it can't come down and then bounce. So, and we have that danger, of course. If it does come down, if this was to be a fake out and this doesn't hold, it doesn't bounce, then go bearish. And if we break that level, in my opinion, and this was a pullback and that not bounce, then we are likely to go further down, and we can talk about that some other time. Talked on many videos. So that from that perspective, the RSI is looking good, bullish at the moment. Here we're seeing many weeks of small accumulation, but still bullish. So we want to see that continue to the upside. And then that's the decision maker. This level, if it breaks this level, I would be bullish. I will go 100%. That's pretty much it from the weekly perspective. If we were to look at Ichimoku Cloud, what we see from a weekly is nothing that we can really use. So what we're going to do is go to the daily now. Looking at the daily chart with the RSI, we can see that there is this strong movement to the upside of some sort, and the line sort of relatively held. And you can probably argue that this line plays a number of levels like that. But what we see is each time it was held. And we've got this trend line. We see the moving averages come to place, but more so the Fibonacci was the main one. And so the weekly was a better signal than this for the RSI. From the MACD perspective, we can make this bigger. Let's just do that again. Let's just put this vertical. This is our selling climax, and this is where we'll break out. So let's look at the MACD from that perspective. You can see from that, there was a bullish. So that's a selling climax. And then we start to have this bullish divergence take place. Yep. And went sideways for a while and then went up again. I think when we're going above 50%, or the zero, the mean, that's when things went bullish. So let's look at that. And you can say that is our middle. That's when things from the MACD went bullish. Okay, so we've got the crossover and so on. here, if we look at this one here as well, this is even more bullish from a MACD perspective than RSI. The RSI is on a good trend. We had this trend, and now we're having this trend, and we don't want to see it drop below it. And what we have, previous resistance, and we went above it. I believe if we go above this one, we're going to go, it's going to take off. So what we have is resistance here, and the next level is to the 0.382. What value is that? Well, we can put the pricing in there. So 22,400 and so is the next main resistance. And I don't know why I got this, but I can get rid of that. Okay, that is the moving average. Okay, so that's what we have from the RSI perspective. The MACD is pretty much hidden bullish divergence. It's played out. That was the move. And we still have an ascending MACD, which is matching the RSI, and that's pretty bullish. Looking good so far. And it's showing the bottom. I don't think it's the... Anyway. Well, what we're looking for is an entry. The entry is giving us a good signal at the moment from the daily perspective. Let's look at, from another perspective, the Ichimoku Cloud. The Ichimoku Cloud, when we look at in the past, when we get this green shade coming in, it's more like confirmation. And let's have a look, a closer look from the daily perspective. So when this Ichimoku Cloud thins, that's pretty much showing resistance to the upside is weakened and it's crossed over, and therefore we get this breakthrough, and then it looks like it's acting as support. This green crossover again is showing us that it's bullish now, and from a daily perspective, Ichimoku Cloud. So we've got red, green, red, green. Here we went through the red, and we got the green sometime later, much more delayed. And here we got our green showing weakness, and that's why we got that spike. And now we're getting another green showing that there's weakness in resistance. So this is giving us a positive result. Now, can we use this as support? That is a question, and that's the way to look at it at this point. Looking at the Bollinger Band. The Bollinger Band shows us that we were in a squeeze here, downward momentum, and then when we broke up, this thing started to turn upwards. This is the indication on the daily, the Bollinger Band showing us bullish results and coming to a squeeze again, and then another move. And that's basically the formation. But here we had the Bollinger Band coming tight. The squeeze was here and it's gone up. So when we look at another, when we look at the other one, let's keep going. We had the squeeze and now we're breaking up. This Bollinger Band has three variations or deviations. We've hit the deviations to the top side. We at the moment we're on the second deviation, which tends to play a lot of resistance in the past, and it's playing resistance again as we go. Here we're doing the same, where we're having a deviation of two, playing resistance, and then coming back to the mean and so on. Continuing on, looking at the daily and they're looking at the current levels. I've got this Fibonacci set up. Currently, the weekly resistance is at the 0.5 Fibonacci, and you can see that's also the daily resistance level. So we haven't quite reached there. What we're looking for is potentially a pullback for this cup shape and likely to be support. And these two daily levels where there was previous resistance and support in this area is likely to play support. If we drop below this, it's not going to be good. However, we still got that last level. If we don't get support from there, then it's going to be pretty bearish, and then that just could be a fake out, and then that just will continue down. So we have that level, last level of support, and we don't want to drop that. If we drop that, it's going to go really deep. So looking from that perspective, things are looking good.